Raging Phoenix is a martial arts film that comes from Thailand. The movie is just an absolute delight because it does a few things to make itself different, but for the most part, it is just a pretty straight-up excellent martial arts movie. There's some different fighting styles mixed in there, and there's also a fantasy element in the storyline as well, which creates some amazing sets for the fight choreography to, you know, take place at, and it's just the choreography of the fights, these locations mixed with just the mix of fighting styles. It's a really, really great movie. It's one that even people who don't necessarily like martial arts, I think, you know, people willing to give this movie a shot will just be amazed at how it really keeps you on your feet, keeps you entertained, and it's just an absolute blast to watch from start to finish. Raging Phoenix has a simple storyline. It's about a gang in Thailand that's abducting women. And what actually happens is the main character in the movie, there's an attempted abduction by this gang, but she's actually saved by a group of victims. The victims being men, you know, that have known women that have been abducted in some way by this gang. So these victims, their sisters have been abducted, or one of the main characters, Sanem, his wife has been abducted on their wedding day. So they go ahead and they train this girl that they've saved to work with them to hopefully get to the bottom of this gang, find their base, and save, you know, all these women that have been kidnapped. The movie's cliche just in terms of, you know, this the main character being trained, the training sequences for her to become a good fighter so that she can, you know, help, you know, essentially find the bad guys in their lair and, you know, save a lot of people. But I don't find that this movie is all that cliche because it throws a lot of things in to keep it really, really interesting. And to start out with is actually, I really like that it mixes fighting styles. I don't know a lot about martial arts, but it's really interesting. There's like drunken fighting where they drink a lot of alcohol and the buzz sort of gets their adrenaline pumping so that they can, you know, it's a really interesting way to fight. And not only that, but then there's also, they sort of do like breakdance fighting. So what's some people may or may not like is there's, you know, definitely interesting music playing during the fight scenes because the main characters are like breakdancing and fighting at the same time, but mixing that with drunken fighting as well, it's just sort of creates this odd style that I find really interesting. And then towards the latter half of the film, it definitely switches gears and it goes for, you know, fighting that is more of a sense for like finishing moves and, you know, really elaborate kicks and punches that will really, you know, defeat your opponent. So all the ways that the fighting is mixed in the movie, I really, really enjoyed. What actually makes the fighting really amazing, though, is that the set pieces that the movie creates. The fighting is always happening in different, diverse locations, and I really have essentially the way the storyline moves to thank for that, because towards the end of the film, as you find out more about this gang, what they're doing with these women that they're abducting, it has sort of a fantasy vibe to it about people, pheromones, and perfumes. I won't give it all away. It's not too difficult to grasp, but it's definitely not all that realistic. And when it gets to that storyline and gets to the lair where, you know, this gang is developing this odd sort of perfume, the sets are just, like, in a lot of places really colorful. There's a lot of interesting fog. And then that creates some really interesting, you know, places for the fights to take place and a lot of different set pieces to use, and that really, really helps the movie quite a bit. There's one fight in particular that I just love. It's a few of the characters are fighting on these suspension bridges. There's about two or three suspension bridges, you know, with pieces of wood that are, you know, falling off where they're stepping, but they're like three bridges on top of one another, so the characters are like using the ropes on the one bridge to get to the other one and are going down through. It's just, and you know, they're rickety, so they're using that momentum to jump from place to place, and it is just one of my favorite scenes in the movie. The only real criticisms I have are actually more of just preferences. Like, I preferred the fighting towards the end of the movie than the fighting at the beginning. The drunken style of fighting, although I thought it was interesting, it wasn't my favorite, but the good thing is it didn't overstay its welcome, because as I said, it keeps the variety up. It keeps the fighting styles interchanged. So we don't see that all the time. So that's, you know, it's not really a disadvantage because it's not my preference, but it doesn't come up too often. The humor I didn't find too funny though. The film attempted humor quite a bit, and I didn't think it was, you know, all that funny. But that certainly didn't, you know, hurt my overall enjoyment of the movie because the moments that the humor is being created, that's just, you know, driving the story a little bit forward. But there's so many fight scenes to keep the movie going that it really doesn't hurt it very much. So the movie definitely is not boring. It has all these wonderful fight sequences, and it's not just that there's one or two and then the grand finale. There are a lot in the beginning, a lot in the middle, and a lot in the end. But as I think a fair amount of action movies are guilty of, it's the last scenes in the movie, the last fights that are really, really spectacular. It just gets so intense in these final fights. You'd wonder how many kicks to the face or, you know, punches to the gut one person can take. But even though it is just intense like that, I'd say this intensity is like the last 40 minutes of the movie. Like, it doesn't let up. These fights just continue and continue, and they're just so well done that I think almost anyone will be, you know, entertained watching them.